What's up, you guys? Today we'll be reading from the book of Zechariah, chapters 1 through 8. I'm excited because I've heard this name mentioned before, but I have no clue what it is related to, what's the purpose of Zechariah. So it's good to learn new things. That's why it's good to read the whole Bible. Don't just get stuck on them verses that you know. You know, and don't just read a verse. One of my mentors, he is deceased, but you can go and look up all of his work. Miles Monroe, he says, don't you start nothing from there. Therefore, you need to go back and read all from the beginning, even the chapter before that, to understand why are they saying therefore. Because that has purpose. Therefore is a play off something else. So read it. Understand it. This ain't an easy process, but it's so worth it once you do it. So let's get into the book of Zechariah, chapters 1 through 8. And we got to give praise and honor to God, to Christ, and to the Holy Spirit. I thank you and I honor you and I need you. Please help me and my brothers and sisters across the globe. Thank you. Chapter 1. Zechariah exhorts the Jews to repent. In the 8th month, in the 2nd year of Darius, came the word of the Lord unto Zechariah, the son of Berechiah, the son of Iddo, the prophet, saying, the Lord have been sore displeased with your fathers. Therefore, say thou unto them, this said the Lord of hosts, turn ye unto me, said the Lord of hosts, and I will turn unto you, said the Lord of hosts. Be ye not as your fathers, unto whom the former prophets have cried, saying, this said the Lord of hosts, turn ye now from your evil ways and from your evil doings. But they did not hear, nor hearken unto me, said the Lord. Your fathers, where are they? And the prophets, do they live forever? But my words and my statutes, which I have commanded my servants, the prophets, did they not take hold of your fathers? And they returned and said, like as the lords of hosts, thought to do unto us according to our ways and according to our doings, so have he dealt with us. The visions of the horses upon the 4th and the 20th day of the 11th month, which is the month of Sabbat in the 2nd year of Darius, came the word of the Lord unto Zechariah, the son of Berechiah, the son of Iddo, the prophet, saying, I saw by night, and behold, a man riding upon a red horse. He stood among the myrtle trees that were in the bottom, and behind him were red horses, speckled and white. Red horses, speckled and white. Then said I, O my Lord, what are these? And the angel that I talked with me said unto me, I am Anetzo. Then said I, O my Lord, what are these? And the angel that talked with me said unto me, I will shew thee what these be. Okay, y'all spitting in the Bible? And the man that stood among the myrtle trees answered and said, these are they whom the Lord have sent to walk to and fro through the earth. And they answered the angel of the Lord that stood among the myrtle trees and said, we have walked to and fro through the earth. And behold, all the earth sitteth still and is at rest. Then the angel of the Lord answered and said, O Lord of hosts, how long wilt thou not have mercy on Jerusalem and on the cities of Judah? against which thou hast had indignation these 70 years? Question. And the Lord answered the angel that talked with me with good words and comfortable words. So the angel that communed with me said unto me, cry thou, saying, this said the Lord of hosts, I am jealous for Jerusalem and for Zion with a great jealousy. And I am very sore and displeased with the heathen that are at ease. For I was but a little displeased, and they helped for the affliction. Therefore this said the Lord, I am returned to Jerusalem with mercies. My house shall be built in it, said the Lord of hosts. A line shall be stretched forth upon Jerusalem. Cry yet, saying, this said the Lord of hosts, my cities through prosperity shall yet be spread abroad, and the Lord shall yet confront Zion, and shall yet choose Jerusalem. The vision of the four horns and the four smiths. Then lifted up mine eyes and saw, and behold, four horns. And I said unto the angel that talked with me, what be these? And he answered me, these are the horns which have scattered Judah and Israel and Jerusalem. And the Lord shewed me four carpenters. Then said I, what come these to do? And he spake, saying, these are the horns which have scattered Judah, so that no man did lift up his head, but these are come to fray them, to cast out of the horns of the Gentiles, which lifted up their horn over the land of Judah, to scatter it. Chapter 2. The Lord will choose Jerusalem. I lifted up mine eyes again and looked, and behold, a man with a measuring line in his hand. Then said I, whither goest thou? And he said unto me, to measure Jerusalem to see what is the breadth thereof and what is the length thereof. And behold, the angel that talked with me went forth, and another angel went out to meet him and said unto him, run, speak to this young man, saying, Jerusalem shall be inhabited as towns without walls for the multitude of men and cattle therein. For I said, the Lord will be unto her a wall of fire round about, and will be the glory in the midst of her. Ho, ho, come forth and flee from the land of the north, said the Lord, for I have spread you abroad as the four winds of the heaven, said the Lord. Deliver thyself, O Zion, that dwell with the daughter of Babylon. For this said the Lord of hosts, after the glory have he sent me unto the nations which spoiled you, for he that touch you touched the apple of his eye. For behold, I will shake mine hand upon them, and they shall be a spoil to their servants. And ye shall know that the Lord of hosts have sent me. Sing and rejoice, O daughter of Zion, for lo, I come and will dwell in the midst of thee, said the Lord. And many nations shall be joined to the Lord in that day, and shall be my people, and I will dwell in the midst of thee, and thou shalt know that the Lord of hosts have sent me unto thee. And the Lord shall inherit Judah, his portion of the Holy Land, in the Holy Land, and shall choose Jerusalem again. Be silent, O all flesh, before the Lord, for he is raised up out of his holy habitation. be silent. Chapter 3. The Lord will send his servant. And he shewed me, Joshua the high priest, standing before the angel of the Lord, and Satan standing at his right hand to resist him. I'm going to repeat that. Chapter 3. The Lord will send his servant. And he shewed me, Joshua, the high priest, standing before the angel of the Lord, and Satan standing at his right hand to resist him. And the Lord said unto Satan, the Lord rebuke thee. O Satan, even the Lord that hath chosen Jerusalem rebuke thee. Is not this a brand plucked out of the fire? Now Joshua was clothed with filthy garments and stood before the angel. And he answered and spake unto those that stood before him, saying, take away the filthy garments from him. And unto him he said, behold, I have caused thine iniquity to pass from thee, and I will clothe thee with change of garment and change of raiment. And I said, let them set a fair metre upon his head. So they set a fair metre upon his head and clothed him with garments. And the angel of the Lord stood by. And the angel of the Lord protested unto Joshua, saying, this said the Lord of hosts, if thou wilt walk in my ways, if thou wilt keep my charge, then thou shalt also judge my house, and shalt also keep my courts. And I will give thee places to walk among these that stand by. Verse 7. This said the Lord of hosts, if thou wilt walk in my ways, and if thou wilt keep my charge, then thou shalt also judge my house, and shalt also keep my courts. And I will give thee places to walk among these that stand by. Yes, hallelujah. Hear now, O Joshua, the high priest, thou and thy fellows that sit before thee, for they are men wounded. For behold, I will bring forth my servant, the branch. For behold, the stone that I have laid before Joshua, upon one stone shall be seven eyes. Behold, I will engrave the graving thereof, said the Lord of hosts, and I will remove the iniquity of that land in one day. In that day, said the Lord of hosts, shall ye call every man his neighbor under the vine and under the fig tree? Chapter 4. The Lord's house will be rebuilt. And the angel that talked with me came again and walked me and waked me as a man that is wakened out of his sleep. So I mess up there. Chapter 4. The Lord's house will be rebuilt. And the angel that talked with me came again and waked me as a man that is wakened out of his sleep, and said unto me, what seest thou? And I said, I have looked, and behold, a candlestick, all of gold, with a bowl upon the top of it, and his seven lamps thereon, and seven pipes to the seven lamps which are upon the top thereof, and two olive trees by it, one upon the right side of the bowl, and the other upon the left side thereof. So I answered and spake to the angel that talked with me, saying, what are these, my Lord? Then the angel that talked with me answered and said unto me, knowest thou not what these be? And I said, no, my Lord. Then he answered and spoke unto me, saying, This is the word of the Lord unto the Zerubbabel, saying, not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, said the Lord of hosts. Child. That was in verse 6. And on verse 7, who art thou, O great mountain? Before Zerubbabel, thou shalt become a plain, and he shall bring forth the headstone thereof with shoutings, crying, grace, grace unto it. Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, the hands of Zerubbabel have laid the foundation of this house. His hands shall also finish it. And thou shalt know the Lord of hosts have sent me unto you. For who hath despised the day of small things? For they shall rejoice and shall see the plummet in the hand of Zerubbabel with those 7. And they are the eyes of the Lord which run to and fro through the whole earth. Hold on. Which run to and fro through the whole earth. Then answered I, and said unto him, what are these 2 olive trees upon the right side of the candlestick, and upon the left side of the candlestick? I like how we're able to ask questions. Like when we see it and we don't know it, what is that? So I'm going to repeat verse 11. Then answered I, and said unto him, what are these 2 olive trees upon the right side of the candlestick and upon the left side thereof? And I answered again and said unto him, what be these 2 olive branches which through the 2 golden pipes empty the golden oil out of themselves? And he answered me and said, knowest thou not what these be? And I said, no, my Lord. Then he said, these are the 2 anointed ones that stand by the Lord of the whole earth. That's good to know. So what type of trees those are? Olive trees? So mention olive branches and then olive trees. Olive trees are the 2 anointed ones that stand by the Lord of the whole earth. It's so funny how things happen and things are said. And what, I just gotta say hallelujah. Visions of a flying scroll. Chapter 5. Visions of a flying scroll. Then I turned and lifted up mine eyes and looked, and behold a flying roll. And he said unto me, what seest thou? And I answered, I see a flying roll. The length thereof is 20 cubits. And the bread thereof 10 cubits. Then said he unto me, this is the curse that go forth over the face of the whole earth. For everyone that steal shall be cut off as on this side according to it. And everyone that swear shall be cut off as on that side according to it. Verse 4. I will bring it forth, said the Lord of hosts. And it shall enter into the house of the thief and into the house of him that swear falsely by my name. And it shall remain in the midst of the house and shall consume it with the timber thereof and the stones thereof. Vision of a woman in a basket. Then the angel that talked with me went forth and said unto me, lift up now, thine eyes and see what is this that go forth. And I said, what is it? And he said, this is an ephah that go forth. He said, moreover, this is their resemblance through all the earth. And behold, there was lifted up a talent of lead. And this is a woman that sit in the midst of the ephah. And he said, this is wickedness. And he cast it into the midst of the ephah. And he cast the weight of the lead upon the mouth thereof. Then lifted up mine eyes. Then I lifted up mine eyes and looked, and behold, there came out two women, and the wind was in their wings, for they had wings like the wings of a stork, and they lifted up the ephah between the earth of the heaven. Then said I to the angel that talked with me, whither do these bear the ephah? And he said unto me, to build it in a house in the land of Shinar, and it shall be established and set there upon her own base. Chapter 6. The Vision of the Four Chariots. And I turned and lifted up mine eyes and looked, and behold, there came four chariots out from between two mountains, and the mountains were mountains of brass. In the first chariot were red horses, and in the second chariot, black horses, and in the third chariot, white horses, and in the fourth chariot, grizzled and bay horses. Then I answered and said unto the angel that talked with me, what are these, my Lord? And the angel answered and said unto me, these are the four spirits of the heavens, which go forth from standing before the Lord of all the earth. The black horses which are therein go forth into the north country, and the white go forth after them, and the grizzle go forth toward the south country. And the bay went forth and sought to go, that they might walk to and fro through the earth. And he said, Get you hence, walk to and fro through the earth. So they walked to and fro through the earth. Then cried he upon me and spake unto me, saying, behold, these that go toward the north country have quieted my spirit in the north country, priest and king. And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, take of them of the captivity, even of Heldai, of Tobijah, and of Jediah, which are come from Babylon, and come thou the same day, and go into the house of Josiah the son of Zephaniah. Verse 11. Then take silver and gold, and make crowns and set them upon the head of Joshua, the son of Jehozadak, the high priest. Jehozadak, the high priest, and speak unto him, saying, this speaketh the Lord of hosts, saying, behold, the man whose name is the branch, and he shall grow up out of his place, and he shall build the temple of the Lord. Even he shall build the temple of the Lord, and he shall bear the glory, and shall sit and rule upon his throne, and shall be a priest upon his throne. And the council of peace shall be between them both. And the crown shall be to Helam, and to Jabijah, and to Tobijah, and to Jediah, and to Hen the son of Zephaniah, for a memorial in the temple of the Lord. And they that are far off shall come and build in the temple of the Lord. And ye shall know that the Lord of hosts have sent me unto you. And this shall come to pass. if ye will diligently obey the voice of the Lord your God. So it will come to pass. The words of the Lord's prophets, chapter 7. And it came to pass in the fourth year of King Darius that the word of the Lord came unto Zechariah in the fourth day of the ninth month, even in Chesalu, when they had sent unto the house of God Sherezer and Ragamalek and their men to pray before the Lord and to speak unto the priests which were in the house of the Lord of hosts and to the prophets, saying, should I weep in the fifth month, separating myself so as I have done these as... Verse 3. It's okay to make mistakes. And to speak unto the priest, which were in the house of the Lord of hosts, and to the prophets, saying, should I weep in the fifth month, separating myself as I have done these so many years? Then came the word of the Lord of hosts unto me, saying, speak unto all the people of the land, and to the priest, saying, when ye fasted and mourned in the fifth and the seventh month, even those 70 years, did ye at all fast unto me, even unto me? And when ye did eat, and when ye did drink, and did not eat for yourselves, and did for yourselves, question, should ye not hear the words which the Lord hath cried by the former prophets, when Jerusalem was inhabited, and in prosperity, and the cities thereof round about her, when men inhabited the south and the plain? Question. So the cause of the captivity. And the word of the Lord came unto Zechariah, saying, this speak the Lord of hosts, saying, execute true judgment, and shew mercy and compassion every man to his brother, and oppress not the widow, nor the fatherless, the stranger, nor the poor, and let none of you imagine evil against his brother in your heart. But they refused to hearken, and pulled away the shoulder, and stopped their ears that they should not hear. Verse 12. Yea, they made their hearts as an adamant stone, lest they should hear the law. The power just went out. But we gonna continue this thing, baby. Because your girl got that flashlight on her phone. Okay. It just came back on, so we're good. Excuse me for the technical difficulties. So I'm going to begin at verse 12. Yeah, they made their hearts as an adamant stone, lest they should hear the law and the words which the Lord of hosts have sent in his spirit by the former prophets. Therefore came a guest of great wrath from the Lord of hosts. Therefore it came to pass that as he cried, and they would not hear, so they cried, and I would not hear, said the Lord of hosts. But I scattered them with the whirlwind among all the nations whom they knew not. This the land was desolate after them, that no man passed through, nor returned, for they laid the pleasant land desolate. Chapter 8. The restoration of Jerusalem. Again, the word of the Lord of hosts came to me, saying, "This said the Lord of hosts, I was jealous for Zion with great jealousy, and I was jealous for her with great fury. This the Lord, I am returned unto Zion, and will dwell in the midst of Jerusalem. And Jerusalem shall be called a city of truth, and the mountain of the Lord of hosts, the holy mountain. This said the Lord of hosts, there shall yet old men and women dwell in the streets of Jerusalem, and every man with his staff in his hand for very age. And the streets of the city shall be full of boys and girls playing in the streets thereof. This said the Lord of hosts, if it be marvelous in the eyes of the raiment of this people in these days, should it also be marvelous in mine eyes? Said the Lord of hosts. This said the Lord of hosts, behold, I will save my people from the east country and from the west country, and I will bring them, and they shall dwell in the midst of Jerusalem. And they shall be my people, and I will be their God. In truth and in righteousness, the Jews are encouraged to build. This said the Lord of hosts, let your hands be strong. Yea, the hair in these days, these words by the month of the prophets, which were in the day the foundation of the house of the Lord of hosts was laid, that the temple might be built. For before these days, there was no hire for man, nor any hire for beast. Neither was there any peace to him that went out and came in because of the affliction. For I set all men, everyone against his neighbor. But now I will not be unto the residue of this people, as in the former days, said the Lord of hosts. For the seed shall be prosperous, the vine shall give her fruit, and the ground shall give her increase, and the heavens shall give their due. And I will cause the raiment of this people to possess all these things. And it shall come to pass that as ye were a curse among the heathen, O house of Judah, and house of Israel, so will I save you, and ye shall be a blessing. Fear not, but let your hands be strong. For this said the Lord of hosts, as I thought to punish you, when your fathers provoked me to wrath, said the Lord of hosts, and I repented not. So again have I thought in these days to do well in Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. Fear ye not. These are the things that ye shall do. Speak ye every man the truth to his neighbor. Execute the judgment of truth and peace in your gates. And let none of your image evil in your hearts against his neighbor. And love no false oath. For all these are things that I hate, said the Lord. Many nations will come. And the word of the Lord of hosts came unto me, saying, this the Lord of hosts, the fast of the fourth month, and the fast of the fifth, and the fast of the seventh. Hold on. Many nations will come, and the word of the Lord of hosts come unto me, saying, this said the Lord of hosts, the fast of the fourth month, and the fast of the fifth, and the fast of the seventh, and the fast of the tenth shall be the house of Judah joy and gladness and cheerful feast. Therefore, love the truth and peace. This said the Lord of hosts. It shall yet come to pass that there shall come people and the inhabitants of many cities, and the inhabitants of one city shall go to another, saying, let us go speedily to pray before the Lord and seek the Lord of hosts. And I will go also. Yeah, many people and strong nations shall come to seek the Lord of hosts in Jerusalem and to pray before the Lord. Completing verse 23, this said the Lord of hosts, in those days it shall come to pass that 10 men shall take hold out of all languages of the nations, even shall take hold of the skirt of him that is a Jew, saying, we will go with you, for we have heard that God is with you. And that is the end of the reading today. We read the book of Zechariah, chapters 1 through 8. Yeah. And Zechariah was pretty great. Three things that caught my attention was chapter 8, verse 17. And let none of you imagine evil in your hearts against his neighbor. And love no false oath. For all these are things that I hate, said the Lord. Something else that caught my attention. Chapter 7, verse 5. Speak unto all the people of the land, and to the priests, saying, when ye fasted and mourned in the fifth and seventh month, even those 70 years, did ye at all fast unto me? Even to me? Yeah, that's a deep question. Something else that caught my attention. Chapter 8. Chapter 8, verse 8. Let's go with that. And I will bring them, and they shall dwell in the midst of Jerusalem, and they shall be my people, and I will be their God in truth and in righteousness. And one more thing that caught my attention. We can go on for days because your girl got notes. But I'm going to keep it sweet, because I got more reading to do. Okay, something else that caught my attention was, Holy Spirit, what should I share with the people? What should I share with the people? Okay. Chapter 3, verse 1. And he showed me Joshua the high priest standing before the angel of the Lord, and Satan standing at his right hand to resist him. Okay. Y'all, we gotta be prepared. Because sometimes the enemy is trying to resist us. So that was a good one, Holy. Hey, and that's the end of the reading of the word today. I love you guys. I'm out.
You can't be everything to everybody. I want to be your lover, your best friend, your Batman, Spider-Man. Fight the pilot, shooting down your rivals. And I want